Hi everyone, this is Anders Hejlsberg, lead architect of the TypeScript project and technical fellow at Microsoft. Today I'm here to talk about Project Corsa, which is our effort to port the TypeScript compiler and toolset to native code. Now since the inception of TypeScript more than a decade ago, TypeScript's been written in itself, and that's brought a lot of benefits, but it's also consistently brought some challenges, in particular around performance and scalability. The JavaScript runtime platform is really optimized for UI and browser usage, and not so much for compute-intensive workloads like compilers and system-level tools. When we talk to customers, one of the most commonly reported issues that they face is out-of-memory situations, you know, where their projects are just getting bigger and bigger. And we've likely reached the limit of what we can squeeze out of JavaScript. You know, JavaScript comes with a bunch of overhead that, you know, is troublesome at times. Like, you know, it's a JIT compiled language, so there's always startup cost to JIT compile your code. The very flexible object model with expando properties and so forth, but that adds a lot of cost. You can't inline allocate stuff in structures and so forth. There's no shared memory concurrency. So all of these things mean that we leave money on the table, you know. To sort of illustrate what I mean by that, let me try to start a full compile of the Visual Studio Code project, which is about 1.5 million lines of code. And I'm going to start that with our existing compiler while we keep talking here. About 6 months ago, we started an effort to evaluate moving TypeScript to native code. We knew that we wanted a port, not a rewrite, meaning that we wanted to port our existing compiler lock, stock, and barrel and get all of the same semantics in the new code base. We're now well underway with that. We have more than 100,000 lines ported. Scanner, parser, binder are all pretty much complete. The type checker is about 80% complete. And we're working on language service at this point. We're porting to a language called Go. And some of you might ask, well, why not language, my favorite language, why not C#? Why not Rust? Why not C++? We actually spent a lot of time prototyping in all of the various platforms or all of the various languages. And we found that Go is the most suitable for the particular workload that we're trying to do. It's sort of the lowest level language we can get to that gives us full optimized native code support on all platforms, great control over data layout, the ability to have cyclic data structures and so forth. It gives you automatic memory management with a garbage collector and great access to concurrency. What I'm going to show you now, you saw that compiling Visual Studio Code with our existing compiler takes about a minute. Now we're going to take a look at how long does it take with our new native code compiler. And there we go, a little over 5 seconds, 5.5 seconds. So we're talking more than 10x faster here, which is quite dramatic. You know, that means your projects will load 10 times faster. That means your batch compiles will be 10 times faster. Now, let's try to look at some code here. I said earlier that we're porting, and that means that we are literally taking file by file, function by function, and moving from JavaScript or TypeScript to Go. Let's, for example, try to find here checker.getTypeOfSymbol, which is a function that we have in the type checker. And then let's look at the same function in our old code base. There and put them side by side. And really, you can see that this is a port. This is the same function with all the same code in all the same order, but in Go instead of in TypeScript. Now, what that means is that all of the implicit behaviors that we have in our type checker, such as which type do we pick when there are multiple inference candidates, et cetera, and et cetera, all of the semantics will be the same. All of the code will be different, but the semantics are preserved. And that in turn means that we actually expect to fully be able to replicate the same behavior. Let me try, for example, to introduce an error in this program here. This is actually the source code for the old TypeScript compiler. I'm going to add an extra argument that shouldn't be there. So I'm going to switch to the compiler directory, and now I'm going to set off the old compiler compiling itself. And now we should see an error reported, the error that we just introduced in the code. And sure enough, there's that error. Now let's try it with the new compiler. And you'll see exactly the same error reported, albeit a lot faster, obviously. And that's the experience that we're going for here, really, is this is a plug-and-play replacement for our old compiler. Now, of course, we're not just building a command line compiler. That's one of the artifacts that you know, are part of the TypeScript toolset, but there's also the language service, and which is arguably the more important thing. So I'm going to launch the Go implementation of the language service from inside my Visual Studio project here. Let's do here, and then let's launch VS. And that brings up a copy of Visual Studio with the Go language service now, the native language service running underneath. And you'll see that we have hover implemented here. We have go to definition, we can navigate. And also we have, you know, red squigglies from errors. If I introduce an error, you'll see red squigglies here. Just to give you an idea, this is the Visual Studio code project again, which is 4,500 files, 1.5 million lines of code. Let me try to restart the language server, and you just count here to see how many seconds that's going to take. It's about 1, 2, maybe 3 seconds to completely kill the language server process, restart it, parse all 4,500 files, and bring up semantic errors for the file that I'm in. That's at least 5 times faster than project loads with the old language service. So you're going to see some really nice benefits when in your coding experience. Now, the new language service, we're moving to use the LSP architecture that most languages services use now. LSP TypeScript predates the introduction of LSP, the language server protocol. And we've been wanting for years, really, to move to that, and that's what we're doing here. Now, that means that the language service isn't necessarily going to be a feature-for-feature port of the old language service. It's obviously going to have all the basics. But there are also today, in this modern world, many cases where AI-assisted capabilities are more appropriate than what is in our existing language service, especially when it comes to refactorings and so forth. So we're looking at how to slice and dice that. Now, I wanted to also talk a little bit about how did we actually get all of this extra performance. 10x is pretty dramatic, right? It turns out that about half of the performance gain comes from moving to native code. The other half comes from our ability to use concurrency. Let me try and illustrate this by first compiling, doing a full compile of the old TypeScript compiler, using the old TypeScript compiler. So this is about 250,000 lines of code that's being checked and emitted, and it takes about 7 seconds. Let's now try and compile it with our new compiler, but let's force the compiler to run single-threaded. And you'll see it completes in about 2 seconds. So we're getting about 3.5x here from being native. But if we try to do it concurrent, which is the default, you'll see that we complete in less than a second. And here we are about 8x faster. Part of why it isn't 10x here is just because there is one gigantic file in the called the type checker, and we can't parallelize each file. So therefore, you know, that thing is going to take a little bit longer. With projects like Visual Studio, as you saw, we're more than 10x typically. Now, it's interesting that you know, the way we get there, like our existing compiler, we've ported the existing compiler, and the existing compiler has a very functional architecture internally. You know, once we parse and bind files, we have immutable ASTs, and then we can have multiple programs share the same AST abstract syntax tree for each file. Now in the new compiler here, for all of our parsing, binding, and emit, we are fully concurrent, because these are what I often call embarrassingly parallelizable problems. You know, to parse a source file basically means load it into memory, build a data structure that represents the source text in an abstract syntax tree, and then leave it in memory. That's basic, and you can do that for each file. And if you have 8 cores available, you can go 8 times faster because it's completely parallel. Type checking isn't quite parallelizable in the same manner, because, you know, types kind of reach across multiple files. So what we do there is that instead of running one type checker on a program, we create some number of type checkers. Currently, it's hardwired to be 4. And then we give each of those type checkers the same program, but tell them to check a quarter of the files. And then they go off to work. And of course, there's some duplication there. Each of those 4 type checkers will all resolve all the the built-in types from the standard library and so forth. But most of the resolution and checking is local. And so we see that we can get 2 to 3 times faster in the check phase at the cost of maybe consuming 20 to 25% more memory. But overall, we still consume less memory than we used to. Okay, so at this point, now that we're public with the repo, we have a single project command line compiler that's about 80% complete, I would say. It doesn't currently support JavaScript and JSDoc or JSX, but that's just a waypoint. We are moving towards completing that. We have the language service underway, but it's still early. We do expect within this year to have a fully functional replacement command line compiler that supports JSDoc, JSX, project references, possibly incremental compile as well. A new inter-process API such that from other languages you can talk to the compiler. And we are, of course, looking at using this performance gain that we now have of 10x to think about new kinds of AI features that become possible, such as, you know, immediate type checking of an LLM's output, provision of semantic information in the LLM prompts, and so forth. Now, I hope you'll go check out the new GitHub repo, build it, try it on your own projects, and share your experiences, and if you find issues, please share them as well. Thank you.